blood supply. Each intercostal space has arteries and veins for their blood supply. There are 11 intercostal arteries for 11 posterior intercostal spaces running along the upper border of the space in the costal groove. Each of these arteries gives a collateral branch which runs along the lower part of the respective intercostal space. Anteriorly, there are 9 intercostal spaces. The internal thoracic, runs at a distance of 2 cm from the lateral border of sternum, parallel to the sternum. This internal thoracic artery gives 2 anterior intercostal arteries in 1st to 6th intercostal spaces. Anteriorly, there are 9 intercostal spaces. One artery, the anterior thoracic or internal thoracic, runs at a distance of 2 cm from the lateral border of sternum, parallel to sternum. This anterior thoracic artery gives 2 anterior intercostal arteries in 1st to 6th intercostal spaces. 2 anterior intercostal arteries each in 7th to 9th anterior spaces are provided by musculophrenic artery, which is one of the terminal branches of the internal thoracic arteries. These arteries are smaller than the posterior intercostal and its collateral branch. The posterior intercostal and its collateral branch supply 2/3 of the intercostal space and anastomose with the 2 anterior intercostal arteries. The 10th and 11th posterior intercostal arteries directly enter the anterior abdominal wall. These intercostal arteries supply the muscles, overlying skin, joints, parietal pleura, parietal peritoneum, and the periosteum of the ribs. The venous drainage, anterior aspect. 7th to 9th spaces drain in the vena comitans along the musculophrenic vein, which continue up with the venae comitans of the internal thoracic vein. Internal thoracic vein drains vein of 6th to 1st intercostal spaces. Finally, the 2 vena comitans drain into the brachiocephalic vein. Posterior aspect. The 1st intercostal vein on the right side and left side drain into the respective brachiocephalic veins. 2nd to 4th intercostal veins join to form superior intercostal vein. The right one drains into venae zygose and the left one drains into left brachiocephalic vein. 5th to 11th posterior intercostal veins on the right side and in vena zygose. 5th to 8th posterior intercostal veins and in the accessory hemiazygose vein on the left side, and 9th to 11th veins and in the hemiazygose vein. Both these course over the 8th thoracic vertebra to terminate into the vena zygose. The nerve supply of thoracic wall. Nerve supply of thoracic wall reaches the wall from T1 to T12 thoracic spinal nerves. These nerves arise from thoracic segments of spinal cord. Each nerve is attached by 2 roots, a dorsal root characterized by a spinal or sensory ganglia and a ventral root. The 2 roots immediately join to form the trunk at the intervertebral foramen. The trunk of the nerve divides into a dorsal primary ramus and a ventral primary ramus. The dorsal ramus passes backwards for supplying the two muscles of the back. Ventral ramus of the spinal nerve is called the intercostal nerve, and it supplies the muscles of the thoracic wall. In addition, it also supplies parietal pleura, periosteum of the ribs. The lower nerves, T7 to T12, supply parietal peritoneum as well and the muscles of anterior abdominal wall. Since these thoracic nerves, T1 to T12, supply structures beyond thoracic wall, these are classified as typical and atypical intercostal nerves. The typical intercostal nerves keep themselves confined only to thoracic wall structures. These are only T3 to T6. Rest are atypical. The T1 nerve or thoracic 1 nerve is atypical as it joins the important brachial plexus. T2 or thoracic 2 gives a lateral cutaneous branch which supply skin of axilla. The thoracic 7 to thoracic 11 enter the anterior abdominal wall to supply the skin, muscles and parietal peritoneum. These are known as thoracoabdominal nerves. T12 or thoracic 12 is known as subcostal nerve as it is not placed in an intercostal space. It also supplies muscles of anterior abdominal wall. It also gives a cutaneous branch for the gluteal region. The course of the intercostal nerve. The typical intercostal nerve is the thoracic nerve beyond the origin of the dorsal ramus. It lies between internal intercostal membrane and parietal pleura. Then it enters the neurovascular plane between internal intercostal muscle and the beginning of innermost intercostal muscle. It lies then between internal intercostal muscle and pleura, and then between the internal intercostal muscle and sternocostalis. So it reaches close to the lateral margin of the sternum. There, the nerve pierces the internal intercostal muscle, external intercostal muscle, superficial fascia, and skin. It continues as anterior cutaneous branch. The intercostal nerve lies in the costal groove below the posterior intercostal vein and the artery. The order of structure is van. Posterior intercostal vein, posterior intercostal artery, and the intercostal nerve. The branches. The branches of the intercostal nerve. The first branch is the rami communicans. These are gray and white rami communicans connecting the ventral ramus to the thoracic sympathetic ganglia. The white ramus communicans joins the ventral ramus to the ganglia, carrying preganglionic fibers arising from the sympathetic lateral horn of the thoracic spinal cord. These fibers relay in the ganglia, and postganglionic fibers contained in the gray ramus communicans join back into the ventral ramus. Thus, the ganglion gives gray. The mnemonic is GGG, ganglion gives gray. The white ramus communicans is lateral to the gray ramus communicans. The gray rami communicans supply the structures in the skin acting as vasomotor, pilomotor and pseudomotor, and also dilate the vessels of the skeletal muscles. Next branch is the collateral branch. This branch is given off at the tubercle of the rib and runs in the lower part of the respective intercostal space accompanying the collateral branch of posterior intercostal artery and tributary of posterior intercostal vein. The order of these structures is NAV from above downwards, that is, collateral branch of the intercostal nerve, collateral branch of the posterior intercostal artery, and collateral tributary of the posterior intercostal vein. The main intercostal nerve runs in the upper part of the respective intercostal space, the order being VAN from above downwards. That is, posterior intercostal vein, posterior intercostal artery, and intercostal nerve. The collateral nerve also supplies muscles, periosteum of the rib, pleura, and peritoneum. The next is lateral cutaneous branch. It is given off near the angle of the rib. It pierces the muscles and divides into anterior and posterior branches to supply the skin of that area. Next is anterior cutaneous nerve. It is the terminal branch of the intercostal nerve and lies in the anterior region of the respective intercostal space. This also supplies skin of the intercostal space and anastomosis with branch of the lateral cutaneous nerve. The muscular branches are given off by the intercostal nerves and its collateral branch. These nerves supply only muscles of the thoracic wall and no muscle at all of the upper limb.